Well, Henry, I hate to start on kind of a negative note, but I have to ask. There was a tweet that came out literally like as you were arriving to the stage that a reporter said from a source that you were in a workout room screaming last night that there was an injury of some kind. Can you update us on the physical condition if there's any truth to that?
No, absolutely not. I'm good. I'm strong. I'm healthy. I don't know where that came from.
I guess maybe it was probably even given more credence by you not working out today. When did you make the decision not to work out and to do kind of a speech?
No, it's because I'm under science. I'm with NeuroForce One, and they don't want me to do particular things. If you guys have kept up with my social media, I'm good. You know, I don't know what else I got.
That's good.
I mean, shit! I'm here!
Oh, so good.
I feel good.
Cool.
Well, I did have a little bump on my knee, on my right knee, but it was... I hit the edge of the damn corner, and it hurt. That's it.
Just kind of stubbed your knee a little bit.
Yeah, but watch.
All good.
Is that the training room? Is that what
I was at training room. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, that was
cool.
It.
Well, now we know your physical...
You guys have... Is TMZ still following me? What's going on?
Well, now that we know you're physically good, talk about just kind of where you're at right now. I mean, you've accomplished a lot of history in your life, but this would be another historical moment. What's the feeling like for you right now?
It feels good. I mean, this is the biggest fight of my career. I mean, it is. The reality is this guy's tough. Marlon Moraes, he's dangerous. He's got powerful kicks, powerful hands. But this is why I enjoy competition. This is why I do compete. I'm pretty much competing against myself. Like, that's the way I see it. How far can I take this? How far can I take the mind, body, and soul while making history? It's beautiful.
Was there any disappointment that it wasn't TJ? I mean, did that change your course at all? Like, was there something about the matchup itself more than the title? Or, you know, did that change anything for you?
No. It did in the beginning. I was like, whoa. But then once that whole thing with TJ and the EPOs, I was like, man, I never want to fight that guy again. Because it's not fair. So rightfully so, Marlon deserved the title shot. So I'm happy with it. He's more dangerous too. Like, I enjoy competition. I strive through it. There's a reason why I'm the best, man, because I compete against the best.
How much of a boost was it seeing Patricio Pitbull win his title in Bellator, a double champ himself that you train with?
Yeah, for sure, man. It's and again, that's a guy that I emulate. That's a guy that that I admire, that I look up to, that I call, that I get advice from. And to me, Patricio's one of the pound for pounds. Like, you guys may not have him on your radar, but the dude is one nasty human being. I mean, you don't take out Chandler. Chandler could possibly be Khabib. You can make an argument. Mm-hmm. Look at what this featherweight has done. It's incredible. So yeah, he is. He's a big part of my success, I must say.
What about for this camp? How much did you use him for this upcoming fight?
Quite a bit. But it was more to kind of get his input on certain things. Cause, you know, obviously he was focusing on his fight. Mm-hmm. And you know, my training is very tailored, and this is the reason why we didn't work out too, mm-hmm. for that same reason, is making sure we recover. I mean, obviously I think the fans took more what I had to say today than me throwing a freaking knee, mm-hmm. you know, that I bumped.
did you know Marlon didn't like you as much as it seems like he didn't like you? Did you know that before this week or this fight build up?
He probably has a crush on me. I mean, I don't. What is there not to like, schmo?
Everything.
You heard it from the schmo.
Guys, two more questions for Henry.
How do you see this one going down? I mean, what are the danger spots? I mean, I know you're confident in yourself and you're showing yourself to be well-rounded, but where are the danger spots that you gotta stay out of?
Obviously head kicks. I know he's gonna go for knee bars. I've studied this kid to a T. Same thing with Demetrius. Same thing with TJ. It's like it's not a fluke, guys. Like, this is what I do, man. I probably was never a 4.0 student in high school or in elementary, and I probably cheated a lot. But man, I'm a 4.0 student, honorable whatever it is, valedictorian in this. Like, I study, I do my homework. And there's tendencies, there's patterns to everybody, and you have to pinpoint that stuff. Like I said, my process is my preparation, and there's a reason why I'm an Olympic champ.
Henry, I don't know if you've seen last week with Andy Ruiz becoming the first fighter of Mexican descent to become the heavyweight champion of the world, beating Anthony Joshua. And did you watch that fight at all? And if you did, what kind of inspiration does that give you heading into the center?
Yeah, I think being American with Mexican descent, or being Mexican American, however you want to call it, it's a victory for all of us, because that's the lineage of all these Mexican warriors who have won, even going back to Cain Velasquez and MMA. I mean, this stuff has set the path for me to become the best. So, I mean, it's a victory for all of us. And yeah, man, you can look like you can look like the average Joe outside. You can beat up a chiseled guy. You know, so it's inspiring to me. It's inspiring to every little kid that's probably raised in his area that he's gonna touch. And I think that's, you know, congratulations to him.
Thanks, Enner.
And by the way, I have a gold medal and a belt. I'm gonna add another belt later. Haters.